Donald Trump's celebrations of his second impeachment acquittal could be short-lived as he fears he could still face criminal charges. His anxiety was said to have dramatically increased when the ex-president's party's Senate leader Mitch McConnell launched a blistering attack on the former U.S. leader. "He's worried about it," one advisor close to Trump said of potential criminal charges now being. Despite voting to acquit Trump of inciting last month's deadly Capitol riot, powerful Republican McConnell said Trump was still liable for everything he did while he was in office. What do you think of this story? Join the debate in the comments below. He said, "He didn't get away with anything. We have a criminal justice system in this country. We have civil litigation, and former presidents are not immune from being accountable." Addressing fellow senators, he told them, "Former President Trump's actions preceding the riot were a disgraceful dereliction of anyone who decries his awful behavior is accused of insulting millions of. That is an absurd deflection. 74 million Americans did not, and hundreds of rioters did. 74 million Americans did not engineer the campaign of disinformation and rage that provoked it. One person did. Just one. All 50 Senate Democrats and 7 Republicans voted to convict Trump, 10 short of the two-thirds." McConnell said he voted to acquit because the charges were unconstitutional, as Trump was no longer in. "Impeachment was never meant to be the final forum for American justice," he added. While most Senate Republicans pursued his acquittal, even those who voted not guilty warned the former president that criminal charges could be formed. "The ultimate accountability is through our criminal justice system, where political passions are checked," said Republican Senator Thom Tillis of North Carolina. "No president is above the law or immune from criminal prosecution, and that includes former President Trump." President Joe Biden reacted to his predecessor's acquittal, insisting the substance of the charge of incitement to insurrection was not in doubt. "While the final vote did not lead to a conviction, the substance of the charge is not in dispute," Biden said in a statement. Even those opposed to the conviction, like Senate Minority Leader McConnell, believe Donald Trump was guilty of a disgraceful dereliction of duty and practically and morally responsible for provoking the violence unleashed. Democrat House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, whose team prosecuted Trump, was livid at the trial's outcome. She crashed the House impeachment manager's press conference following the trial's conclusion, lashing out at McConnell. "It had not been my intention to come to this press availability," Pelosi said as she spoke to reporters after Saturday. "But what we saw was a cowardly group of Republicans who apparently have no options because they were afraid to defend their job, respect the institution in which they. But why I came over was because I listened to Mitch McConnell," Pelosi continued. "These cowardly senators who couldn't face up to what the president did and what was at stake for our country are now going to have a chance to give a little." Only last month, the U.S. attorney in Washington, D.C. said federal prosecutors are open to investigating Trump's role in inciting the violent riots during which 5 people. "We are looking at all actors here, and anyone that had a role, Michael Schur. If the evidence fits the element of a crime, they're going to be charged." Trump, who is currently lying low in his Mar-a-Lago mansion in Florida, also fears prosecution in New York. State prosecutors are investigating more than £180 million in loans Trump took out on some of his best-known Manhattan properties. Despite the various probes, it has been claimed Trump intends to use his acquittal as a launchpad for a return to the police. Sources close to him say he plans to embark on rallies to target those Republicans who tried to purge him, although that would not be immediate. After his acquittal, Trump said, "It is a sad commentary on our times that one political party in America is given a free pass to denigrate the rule of law, defame law enforcement, cheer mobs, excuse rioters, and transform justice into a tool of political vengeance, and persecute, blacklist, cancel and suppress all people and viewpoints with whom or which they disagree. I always have, and always will be a champion for the unwavering rule of law, the heroes of law enforcement, and the right of Americans to peacefully and honorably debate the issues of the day without malice and without." As Trump plots his future, his legacy within the Republican movement has created a huge divide, with the party now being at civil war.